look at you. You know the words? I was going to say, can you tell something about the song?
This is Time Passes By, right? No, it's not. This is still, this is A Day in My Life. This inspired me to write Time Passes By.
Oh, really?
Okay. A lot of this. And, you know, and I never gave this man a lot of credit. He wrote my first album. His name is Frank Reyes. And I have to always remember to say, give him a shout out because he was very instrumental in the beginning of my career, Tim. Did you know
your success? Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, him and Carlos were great. They were a great team together, and I was fortunate enough to be part of that team.
Absolutely. Around here, we don't call him Frank Reyes. We call him Mr. The Frank Reyes. Yeah.
Mr. The Frank Reyes. Yeah. So, I mean, he really inspired me to be, you know, the writer. And I'm not half the writer here, half the writer he is, but he was a great source of inspiration.
Cool. So he wrote this song. He also wrote, did he write Together Forever too?
Yes, he did.
He wrote that one, mm-hmm. And he wrote Time Pass.
He wrote my entire album. My whole album. And so, yeah.
Other songs that he wrote not by you are, did you do?
I can't think of any songs that he wrote for anyone else. Can you? I'm just kidding.
I'll check Discogs later.
You know, yeah, no, you know, yeah. I'm always here to stir the pot a little bit. Yeah. But he's a great writer. He's got some good music coming up. He did C-Bank. Brenda, yeah. I don't know if she's going to do the C-Bank thing, is she?
Mm-hmm.
But she,
the Joy May. Joy May, yes.
She has a great record coming out soon. He's got Sammy's Own that he's working on as well. So I'm here, we're supporting, we're doing, you know, the best that we can to keep the music alive.
Awesome. I know you mentioned Time Passes By.
And I went on a tangent and didn't talk about Time Passes By.
Hang on a second, go ahead, what?
No, but we have time.
We have time, okay. Come on. All right, this is my remix of Time Passes By, so I'll play this and then... Perfect. Let's have the ladies in the house, everybody. Let's see some hearts up there. Keep caring. Michael Becker's watching. What's up, Michael Becker?
Michael Becker from the West Coast? And now my life without you's just not the same. Sometimes I dream that you're still with me. But when morning comes, I'm alone. If only you could see. Go, 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 go. I'm truly sorry because I pushed you away. I did.
far too cold for me to know. Even though I know you return my chance to love by holding me close in your arms, it were tears that show that your love is based on lies. For all I know, you're just a stranger in my house of love. You call when you want to, take what you want from me, stranger in my house of love. You call when you want to, take what you want from me. Now I'm supposed to trust you.
I haven't sang this song in years.
It's such a great song.
Yeah, let me tell you, I have promoters and stuff that they're asking lately for me to perform the song. Love it, one of my faves.
You want from me, stranger in my house of love. You call when you want to, take what you want from me.
I'm gonna keep you coming until you tell me to stop, right?
What? Yeah. Oh, this is a marathon here. This is what?
Here we go. Zeppelinas in the house, everybody.
Listen, thank you all for hanging out, coming down.
You just got out of the car and came down here and started singing. Thank you.
Thank you all for supporting me all this time. I tell you, it's been a real journey for me from the beginning. Wow, this is Love Me, Need Me, right?
Yeah.
Wow. Another Frank Reyes, Carlos Berrio. This song is called Love Me, Need Me. And I don't think I've ever performed this song. I did in Japan, I did. So check it out.
If you don't believe I need you, then just walk away. 'Cause you won't believe this love would never end. Now your heart is nowhere. In spite of the things we
journey. This is awesome, though. It really is.
All right. You like that?
When I recorded this, I was in a weird position, in a weird place, because it was actually after Together Forever and A Day in My Life and all that stuff. And these songs, they were so meaningful, the way Frank wrote them. And they were just, to me, felt like the combination between Carlos, myself, and Frank. It was magic. Magical.
Yeah, it sure was.
And a lot of people never really, heard some of these songs.
Yeah, you changed music as we know it, too. Can we talk about how did you meet Carlos Berrios?
Originally, I was in a band, boy-girl kind of band, boy-girl group. And we auditioned for Carlos, and it wasn't such a great audition. And we talked about that this week, and we laughed about it. And, it never happened. And one day, out of nowhere, the clear blue, he gave me a call. I'm trying to cut the story because it's kind of a long one.
Right. Yeah.
And he had a record called Make Noise, called me down to see if I was interested in recording the piece, and I agreed to doing it. And after we recorded the piece, I got a little nervous about signing the contract because it was on Profile Records, mm-hmm. and that was kind of another story. But I was lucky enough for him, to actually remember the vocals that I had auditioned with, and thankful enough that he heard.
So he heard you. He knew you.
He heard me. aside the fact that it wasn't such a great audition. And he called me and I did the vocal to Make Noise.
Perfect.
And the record came out on Profile.
That's awesome. I just happen to have Make Noise right here.
Oh! This is not an easy one to sing.
This is the
New York based song too, like very street. DJs loved it. I want to give a shout out always to all the DJs that always supported the Zemelendas from the beginning, from Make Noise all the way to Listen, I Can't Change Your Mind. It's been a journey. And Tim, you've always been a great support system, and I really appreciate that. Even when things weren't happening with freestyle, that it was kind of dwindling away a little, you always kept it alive, you know. And because of you, you're the reason. Why I decided to actually record another freestyle song, honestly.
Thank you.
Yeah.
We appreciate that.
And it's the truth. And it's a sincere truth. You actually did a mix on Rise with Charlie, right?
The house mix with Charlie Baby, within the Rise record,
Within the Rise record, he did that. But we'll talk about that in a minute. But I'm happy to be here with Tim. We're hanging out, we're singing records. This is Make Those.
Carlos told me a story about this record too. He said that after he did it, he took it to the club and then went home, and then somebody called him up on the DJ's name, but called him up and said, dude, you gotta get down here, I don't think you know what you got. And people were losing their minds with this record.
Right,
the giant record.
He looked at it as a DJ himself, you know, so I was kind of lost with it. I recorded it and I just disappeared. And, you know, it did what it did. And, you know, he had an ear. I tell you, from the beginning, Carlos, the chemistry that we've had together all along, it's, you know, undeniable. So that's why I harass him constantly. I'm like, let's work on my next record. But he has, you know, he has great, interesting projects in the making now as well. So there's more of him, you know, to be heard within the next, you know, few
months. He's got a lot of great stuff coming up, yeah.
Yes, he does.
Awesome.
Intro. It was a long intro before I do my verse, and so much to play with when it came down to the track. I'm trying to sing.
Now with the one that you did with Cynthia, I got to explain it to you. She did a new song with Cynthia together, Lisette and Cynthia. Listen, get it?
That's right. Together,
clever.
It's called Listen. And another interesting project. Everything I choose to do, it's always, you know, always, and I challenge myself always, because you have to put your best foot forward. You can never get too comfortable. And I'm happy that she actually joined me on this venture, because, you know, without her, I couldn't, you know, do the project, to be honest. It was already, you know, established that this is what we wanted to do. And she's a great, you know, performer. She's been doing it for longer than I have. So, very interesting, I tell you. Even the vinyl, the turnaround with vinyl, when we decided to do vinyl, it's a long turnaround. Did you know that?
Let's talk about doing the vinyl opposed to not doing vinyl.
Yeah, I mean, we did it just for the DJs, actually, you know, as a throwback, as a collector's item. And the turnaround on vinyl, it could be up to 3 months. I wasn't aware of that. That's why with Rise, when we did Rise, we released it digitally. And the vinyl didn't come out till like 4 weeks, four months later. And fans were like, you're not putting out, even DJs were a little bit upset about it. Because I had no idea. This is all new to me. I was signed to a label.
Yeah.
Now I am the label. So these are things that I'm learning. So we basically did it for fans and for DJs to basically, you know, just have a collector's item. A lot of people don't have turntables anymore. Everything is, you know, this is the wave of the future. So It's not more for you to play, you know, the vinyl, but it's just more of a collector's item. And for DJs that do have turntables, the old school ones, they get a kick out of it. So
cool. So let's say, where can you get the vinyl anyway? Can you, do you have a website that you can
Yes,
go
you
to
can. Well, you can actually get it on my Facebook fan page. I'm currently working on a website. That's a work in progress as well. But for now, you can get it on my Facebook fan page. You can hit up Rex 3 Entertainment as well if you don't want to go through Facebook.
Just inbox you?
And you can, inbox Rex.
Say, I want the vinyl.
So we have the Rise, and we also have Listen available on the page. We have my merchandise, my Rise, as you can tell. I'm trying to support, I'm working on working on the Rise movement because, you know, even with cyberbullying, with emotional, all that stuff, we all go through, you know, our situations. So I'm working on something, you know, just to keep that movement going.
Absolutely. I was going to wear my Rise shirt today, but I said, you know what? You know, it's like wearing a foghat t-shirt to Foghat. Now that I'm... Holy old analogy. Oh, my God. Anyway, this is what the new one sounds like. Exactly like this. Lizette Melendez in the house. This is Lizette and Cynthia. It's called I Can't Change Your Mind.
The more I give, the more you want.
Why would you wanna walk away from me? After all that I've given, I have sacrificed myself for you. Make me love, make me give in. Give you love in any way you like. Noon and night and morning. Suddenly you had a change of heart, and it came with no warning.
The more I give, the more you want. Just never satisfied.
We have several mixes on here. We have the Albert Cabrera mix. We have the Carlos Berrios mix. We have different mixes. So we just decided to, you know, whatever the fans want to play, whatever DJs want to play. Some people have their preferences. Every mix, and as you know, Carlos is a perfectionist. His mix is so crisp, so banging. And I don't even know what to say. I came, you know, I look at this and I, it's a process, you know, just the promotion of the record, making sure everybody's happy with the mixes, everybody, the DJs, the fans, the artists, making sure that Cynthia's happy because it's a joint venture. So we all have to agree with everything that's happening. So, you know, it's a challenge when you go in with another partner, you know, like when you come and you do your show, it's all you. But when you're working with someone else. Exactly.
Yeah, it's gonna be on their schedule too. Crazy. So I know you're gonna be in town in Joliet tomorrow with Cynthia.
Yes.
Performing this song for the first time live in Chicagoland.
And that's the reason why we're here. I mean, just to basically to perform the record together. The unfortunate part about it is that our schedules are always like, you know, she's in one place and I'm in the other. Yeah. So we're just trying to make it so we end up on the same lineup. You know how these lineups are? It's like everybody's on them. So it's going to be fun tomorrow. You know, we don't have enough shows together, which hopefully, you know, eventually, you know, we will. And I know she's going to move on. She has other projects. I have other projects brewing. And that's you're going to be the DJing, one of the DJs tomorrow, right?
Yeah, I'm mixing tomorrow. Rudy Falzo is going to be there, too. The club is Azteca in Joliet tomorrow night. if you could join us, get there early, I suggest, because I don't think it's a big, is it a big place, the banquet hall?
You know, it looks like a big place. We drove by. Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah, it seems pretty, you know, pretty big. So I'm looking forward to doing that tomorrow. It's going to be fun.
Cool. I mean, you're in Chicago a lot, really. I mean, not as, I mean.
Not as much as I used to be.
Every weekend, but, you know, pretty
yeah.
often.
And we came in early, you know, just to come tonight and just to hang out because the show's tomorrow.
So. They came in early to be here. Isn't that cool?
That's right. You know, like I said, listen, you've been supporting me and the whole movement, the whole freestyle community for years, nonstop. So why not?
Thank you.
You know, so we decided, let's take a thing. Let's go hang out with him.
I'm not worthy, but thank you so much. I wanted to not do that. I wanted to play this instead. There we go. I wanted to do my warning.
Oh, my warning.
And then I re-edited it a little bit. So
I heard it before.
Yeah, okay, go ahead.
You say that part that goes... I've said it.
This is a hot mix.
I've said it. You know, I'm gonna put you on the spot. Are you gonna do a mix for my next record?
Absolutely.
The song is called My Warning.
Studio. Hey, let's back in the day, there was a movie called, what was the movie? movie with head-to-head your poster in the background.
I like it like that.
I like it like that, exactly. And yeah, the girl's name in the movie was that, too.
Yeah, yeah, it was.
It was coincidence, so weird. And I remember being in the theater and seeing that in the poster and thinking, hey, look, check it out.
I saw it when that was like a staple back in the day, you know, that movie when it came out. We were watching
it. Did you know they were going to do
that? I had no clue.
Like, were you,
when I watched it for the first time,
were like, hey!
I was so excited when I saw it. I was like, oh my goodness, okay, what? I didn't even ask if they got permission.
It didn't matter.
Until today, it doesn't matter. You know, so I watch it now. I'm like, that's awesome.
We just watched it on TV the other day, too. And I said, hey, check it. Wait till she goes to the bathroom or in their room or wherever.
I think it's a bathroom or
something.
Yeah. And Carlos is working on a project with her as well, Lauren Velez.
Oh, really?
So, yeah, it's a small world, isn't it? It's crazy.
That is crazy. I'm glad I brought it up.
Yep, that was a great point to bring up.
That's so awesome. And I feel like I'm putting you under pressure. You walk in here and I'm making you sing.
No, this is fun. I don't remember half the lyrics that I'm singing, people. So it's just about having a good time today.
I got so many years. I'm a huge fan. I know.
I see that you have. This is what I mean, that you've been supporting forever, you know. So
I told Lizette when she got out of the car, I go, okay, you're going to the studio. I hope you don't think I'm creepy. I've got a lot of your pictures on the wall.
He has an amazing collage of pictures here, not just me. So it goes to show that, you know, you're a fan and you're a great support system. And why not? You know, I always say DJs, listen, without DJs.
There you go.
Where would we be? You have to play our records, even if you don't like them sometimes. You know, as DJs, you know, it's important for you to support. And then after that, let the crowd decide.
Exactly.
You know, and if, you know, and if not, they don't, you know, that's what it's about.
Throw it at the wall if it sticks.
And you know that.
Oh, Carlos Barrios is a genius.
See, that's what I mean. Like, all his beats, they're on point.
In Arizona. My brother Pete's in Madison, Wisconsin. What's up, Pete? Your DJ EBS is watching too.
EBS is in the house. Listen, EBS, don't be fooled. I taught him a lot of his skills.
Yeah,
I taught him how to scratch it. He's very modest. He doesn't want to talk about it.
That's on you. I know. I can tell.
But he, you know, he's a great addition to my show. And we're a work in progress. You know, we're still working and tweaking the show. Shout out to EBS. Shout out to EBS. And this is Love Me, Need Me, right?
I'm actually trying to stump you.
If you don't believe I need you, then just walk away. Cause you once believed this love would never end. Now your heart is nowhere. In spite of the things we
together forever?
I was like 21 or so.
21.
Like in my 20s.
Yeah. And they booked you for your first big show, and you probably all of a sudden now you gotta.
Well, what happened was that after we did Make Noise, it was just Make Noise was like a strictly DJ, you know, type of song. And we were just searching for that one record to, you know, to put me out there. So when I recorded the record, Carlos shopped it around for quite a while.
Yeah.
Nobody liked it. Nobody liked the name. They didn't like the voice. They didn't like the track. They didn't understand it. And, you know, it took quite a long time. And Carlos really had to put his foot down and worked it.
Doors. Yeah. Sorry about Together Forever, too. I heard Carlos, I've heard the story before that he was, it was a freestyle record and he was kind of embarrassed by it. And then so he was in the studio editing it. He did it in his headphones, even though he was writing studio time. Did it in his headphones because he didn't want people to walk by and say, hey, freestyle boy. Right.
Well, you know,
at the time, I mean, there was a transition in music between, you know, it started to become a hip hop nation and
I mean, Carlos has his story in his head. I know he went through a lot with the record. Excuse me, I gotta get my voice tuned for tomorrow. So he went, you know, through his own process of the record, you know, and there are many stories and, you know, things that we don't even know. But it did take a long time. Even my name, like they wanted to change my name, so. We didn't know what direction to take. We tried everything, you know, and nothing worked.
What were they going to change your name to? Did you have an name?
We tried everything. We tried just Lisette. Then we tried Lisette Black. We tried Onyx something. You know, we tried emeralds and rubies and pearls. None of that worked for me.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, he said, you know what? Let's just stick to your name. But I tell you one thing. He just stuck to his guns. He kept doing it over and over. He wouldn't tell me the stories and the, you know, the doors that slammed in his face. He just didn't tell me.
Persistence.
Yeah, you know, and it took a while. You know, there were many nights that nobody ate because we just invested all whatever we had into the record. And, you know, not that I invested anything financially, but time and all that stuff. So.
And then all of a sudden, one record or one radio station picks it up, and then the next, and then the next, and the next, and the next thing you know, you have a hit.
Yeah, yeah.
And you're touring all over the place. I'm sure you're blown up all over the place.
Well, I come from, you know, having nothing going on to having so much going on. I knew nothing about business. All I knew was just that I wanted to sing, perform, and that was it. So, I mean, it was kind of like out of nowhere it felt, but we rehearsed for like a year before I put on my first show. So I was pretty much, you know, polished when it came to performing, but when it came to finances and all that good stuff. I used to spend my money on like, I would pay $500 for a belt.
Yeah,
you know, and, you know, blow it on just nothing.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask you. So you got your first paycheck. What did you spend? What did you buy?
Well, it wasn't necessarily one paycheck, paycheck, you know,
but you
know,
just money in your pocket.
When money started coming in, you know, I just would blow it on ridiculous things, you know, because I couldn't afford what I had, what I was able to afford. Like when you watch my shows in the beginning, my outfits were like put together outfits. I would look through my drawers, like, what can I put together for this? Because there was literally no money coming in. I had no job, no nothing, because I invested all my time on rehearsals. So when I came out, I looked like, you know, a girl struggling pretty much, you know, and after a while I just started spending my money on unnecessary things. But who doesn't do that?
Right, right. You know, so I had to look around.
You know, who doesn't do that? But it's all good, and it's a great story, and I'm thankful to still be doing what I'm doing. It's ridiculous.
So you grew up in Spanish Harlem, so you came from
The project, Spanish
from
Harlem.
The projects. Wow.
Yeah. And my brother still lives in the same apartment where I grew up.
No kidding.
Yeah. So, you know, there's some stuff that I want to go back and touch on, you know, maybe shoot a video around the way, some stuff like that, just to keep that side of me alive.
But they say you can take the girl out of the hood, but you can't take the hood out of the girl.
No, not at all. I mean, the reality is that, you know, I am who I am, and I'm a little rough around the edges, and I don't do it intentionally. It's just that's the way I grew up. You know, I had to fend for myself, and some people take offense to it a little bit. I'm a little, could be a little aggressive, and it's not, well, I don't do it intentional, you know, but it's because if you don't fight, and people, and I say this all the time, if you have a dream, you have to go for it, and people are not going to like you, not everybody's going to love you, and you don't have to apologize for who you are.
Exactly.
You know, you can, you know, make yourself and work on yourself to become a better person, but you don't have to change who you are.
But you got to break some eggs to make an omelet.
Yeah, sure do. So here I am, you know, I'm still, you know, fighting through it, and I'm enjoying it as I go.
Cool.
That's it. You know, that's why I'm here chilling out.
We're thankful. We're thankful. Sometimes you got to make the way. You see what I did there with that? I kind of tied it into a little.
I love that.
Oh,
I love that.
I'm so clever. That's why I'm not on real radio. That's, Zeppa Melendez in the house, everybody. It's literally in the house, in the basement. Yeah.
This is called Make the Way. Song is written by Ron Esco. Produced by Carlos Berrios. Ron, you know Ronnie, right?
Yeah, of course.
He's a great writer as well. Oh. Ronnie, yes.
I didn't know that. You see, I'm learning. I'm taking notes.
Look into my eyes, I knew that day you were the one for me. My love will always come for you, just give a little more to me. Let me fill your empty space and shine my light on you. My love, throw all that's wrong away. True love stronger every day. Make the way.
I haven't heard this in a long time.
Heart and soul can make a change.
We're having a good time, y'all.
Let me be the one to keep you warm at night, giving you exactly what you need. All my love is true. From the time we spend, you'll see. Let me fill your empty space and shine my light on you. My love, throw all that's wrong away. Make the way for you and me to live a true life. Your heart and soul can make a change.
Make the way for you and me
to live a true love stronger every day.
Make the way for you to see
how your heart and soul can make a change.
Make the way for you and me to live a true love stronger. Make the way for you to see how your heart can make a change. Make the way for you and me to make a true love stronger.
made the way for you to see how your heart can make a change.
Here's a workout, Tim. Workout.
Hey, check it out. Brenda's watching. Brenda from C-Bank.
What's up, girl?
What's up, Brenda? Nico's here. He knows the words.
Oh, he knows the words, Nico.
What's up, Zeke? What's up, Kathy?
Kept the love inside. Keep the love left in your eyes. Don't let it slip away. Keep it close to my heart.
I'm trying, y'all. I'm trying to remember this song.
The pain forever.
And I'm following.
There you go. Brenda's watching, so I figured, you know, why don't we do this one? Rise.
Oh, this is the chopped up one.
Oh, this is the, yeah. I'll play the one with everybody here. Hang on.
And I tell you, like I mentioned before, This was a very interesting project as well. Because we didn't know musically where to go with it.
Right.
For the first time in a long time, Carlos wasn't involved in the production of it. So
song is dedicated.
But the twins, let me tell you, they were resilient enough to stay standing, working with me. Because every day I was like, I don't like, can you change this? You know, and they finally brought it up to where it should have been, you know. And I challenged them to become, you know, and just to be on their toes a little bit. And that's what we do for each other. You know, we got to make sure. Yeah, you got to push yourself to bring out the best.
Everything they do is gold, really.
Here we go.
So this is the original, but why don't we do this one? This is the one with everybody.
This is, oh, right, and this is the remix.
Yeah.
This is Rise and Remix with Lisa, Judy Torres, C-Bank, and Carlos Berrios actually
was able to do the remix.
He couldn't do the original because he was tied up, and I finally harassed him. I'm like, you gotta at least jump on the remix for me. And he did so. Shout out to Carlos Berrios, to the team, Dania, C-Bank, Brenda, Sandy Jones, everybody that we hung out with the past few days. You know, great team, Rectory Entertainment. I always forget people. But as far as everything, you know, we had a great weekend with Carlos and the retreat and everything. And Sandy Jones' wife, Mindy. We had a wonderful time. So.
You try to kick me down, but I will. The look in your eyes, there's no way I'll compromise. Stop looking so surprised.
Lisa Lisa's part, a lot of people are confused.
That it has to end this way. I really want you to know. I think it's time you should go. Someday you realize, gave you my heart and all I have. I'm standing my ground.
This is my girl C-Bank in the house, Brenda. CDs, I have vinyl. Once the vinyl is gone, it's gone. I'm gonna, you know, we're gonna move on to other stuff, but
cool.
That's a collector's item right there as well, and so is my Listen record. Cynthia's also selling hers on her website as well, so you can check that if you want a copy of hers on her website. I lost my train of thought.
That's
a
okay.
Shot because he threw all these songs at me that I haven't sang in years. I'm like, my brain is like,
oh, you're not even ready for the next one. But before we do that,
now we're gonna have,
you're not even ready because yeah. So let me. So you sell your T-shirts and stuff, and your hats are all available.
I have my hats available as well for the ladies. I'm trying to do some Rise T-shirts because they're great inspiration to work out. Because ladies, sometimes you know you don't have, you know, it goes for both. Yeah, and I have the pants too. I don't know if you want to zoom in. I don't want to take the whole all your vinyl. You don't want that to fall.
You can swing from this pole right here.
But I have my Rise, my Rise.
There you go. All right.
You see that?
All right, let's see that again. No, I'm kidding. Okay.
But you know, I'm working. And you have the Liza Melendez T-shirt that Rex 3 Entertainment is wearing. So you know, any ways that you can support Liza Melendez, you can always go on my fan page and support that. I'm gonna have my merchandise tomorrow as well on.
Oh, in Joliet, we're going to Azteca.
Azteca.
In
yeah.
Joliet, it's gonna be Lizette and Cynthia, and live along with Rudy Foster. Rudy's gonna be there. Rudy's actually watching right now.
Rudy, what's up?
Hey, Rudy, what's up, man? Put your shirt back on. All right, yeah, there you go.
Yeah, so, you know, you can support in every direction possible. You know?
Perfect. All right, so now I'm throwing a curveball at you. Do you know what this is? This is Lila Payne.
Stay.
There you go.
Okay,
so I recorded another record under a different name, Lila Payne. And
And I'm looking to touch on this again because I would like to revisit the track because it was like a really good moment.
Think it's time that I follow my heart because I've known you so long and you've always been good to me. There were moments when I noticed that you looked at me in a way that was more than just friends for me. There is something I think we both know that tonight I don't want you to go.
I thought I got you that one for sure, but no, it didn't happen. It didn't happen. You're so good at this game.
Well, you know what is? I mean, some of them I couldn't even remember, but I just move my lips with my mic in front of my mouth. That's the trick. And what's then whatever comes out, comes out.
That's awesome.
Yeah, but you know, this song is called Stay. We released it under,
Lila Payne.
Another side of me, but we were never really able to promote it. We didn't have social media the way we do now. So it's a good song. I'm looking to revisit the track and put it on Ladybug Records, which I have my own label. But it's still a work in progress.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah.
I can't tell you how happy I am that you're here. This is so great.
Oh, thank you.
I almost want to cry. But you know what? I don't want to cry.
Oh, I know where you're going.
And I don't want to cry.
This is my jam.
I'm telling Carlos, do something with this. We gotta put it out. We really gotta do it again. We gotta. There you go.
Who knew I'd ever fall in love again? Love was so unkind. A broken heart's not worth the tears love leaves behind. But I will survive. I prayed every night for true love to come up.
That's it. You know what? I have a bucket list. I could just check that one right off. Thank you.
That one, I tell you, that's special because that one I never perform ever because I'm saving it for that time.
For that time. But I squeezed it out of you today. Like
squeezed
I said,
it out of me. Fans, my apologies. I know my vocals are a little bit, but it's all good. It's all about having fun tonight. That's what it's about.
Cool. Cool. So we often do this thing called the Faces Challenge, and that means they throw you under the bus and just think of any song you want to sing. It doesn't have to be yours. It could be any song.
Okay, I'll have some.
All right, I'm going to play this song first while you're thinking of that.
Yes, let me just want to grab something to drink.
Okay, grab something to drink while I'm going to play this one. You might know the words.
I sing whatever to the track?
I'll play something different if you want. All right, cool. So I'll get that together while you're mingling amongst yourselves. She's doing the Faces Challenge, everybody. Oh, my God, this is going to be great. Yeah, everybody does it. There we go. Brendan did it when she was here. We had Julio Mena did it. Cynthia did it, too. I think Cynthia did Dream Boy, Dream Girl with the guys from Law. That was great. And yeah, Brendan did Cardi B. Yeah, that was great. Robert Barco did it, too. Yeah, that was great. Yeah. Yeah, with the guitar, yeah. Oh, that's right. Yes. He did. Oh, that was amazing. So, you got something?
Are you waiting
on me? No, you got it?
I don't have anything, but I'll figure all
right.
it out.
All right, the Faces drums go like this. All right. And what they do is usually DJs play Said You Were My Lady. There you go. Or anything else that you want to sing. All right. You want to use that way? Go ahead. Whatever mic you want to use.
Check, check, check. Check, check.
The vibe you send me reaches deep inside subliminally. Your words, they gently whisper sweet nothings to me. Why don't you make your move? Set it off, baby, me and you. All I wanna do is to get with you. Take you around the world the night through. Yeah. Follow me to a world where our hearts can run free. Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, I need to know love. Tell me, do you want a piece of my goody 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 loving? Do you want a piece of my goody 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 loving? Do you want a piece of my goody 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 loving? Do you want a piece of my goody 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 loving?
Yeah, very nice. Los Abelin is in the house, everybody. Baron Lopez is watching in from Puerto Rico. What's up, Baron Lopez?
Aaron Lopez de Puerto Rico.
Yeah. All right, cool. You want to get another one? Did you want to use that? It? Or?
Well, not right now. No, not right now.
All right, cool. Okay. If you think of something else, we'll do it. Maybe you know the words to this one. Hey.
Hi.
All right. We got a full concert out of her.
You think you know? Tim, you know. He has me up here singing all songs.
Big shout out to my cousin Kiki. Everybody at 418 Records. Giuseppe D.
Been so long since we've been friends in need, and how the love we share in our hearts to try to keep us apart. Took some time. But now you're all I care to think of. You want the best of my love. To keep away from the thoughts that we share. It's to feel the pain that I feel when you're not there. See what you want to see. But please have the faith in me.
First album. They cut my hair. That was not my hair. What happened?
I've seen us come together.
Yo, seriously, they cut me up.
But felt the kiss that makes me love you. Enough to see us through.
Can anybody help me sing up here? Nobody?
Sometimes
nobody? Nobody?
That's why I'm.
Together forever, you're.
Ooh, I can't ad lib. I can't ad lib today.
That's it. Thank you so much. That was great. Big round of applause for Liz Melendez, everybody. All right, everybody. Let's have a look. So, what are your favorite freestyle songs? Give me your top three. What do you got?
Lydia Lee Love.
Oh, okay, great. Well, keep thinking, and I'll get that way.
Because of You.
All right.
Couple Girls. Chrissy Ayiz. Okay. Right. You should know by now. Chrissy Ayiz. Yeah, Lisa.
Okay. Take Me Home, or Can You Feel the Beat?
Actually, both. I'm a big fan.
They're so good.
But, Come Into My Arms.
Oh, Judy. Yvonne, my wife, loves Judy. Yeah. Yeah. That's a good one. Everybody loves
Everybody.
Judy.
Yeah. You know, and the thing is that they all started before I came out. So I used to go to the clubs to watch Judy. I used to watch Cynthia. I used to watch Sweet Sensation, TK. You know, the Cover Girls. I watched everybody. So I used to sit there like, how do I do that? How do I get up there to do that?
Pretty good.
Thank you so much. I came out late, you know, like in the 90s, early 90s, 1990, and they were out 1985, right? Was it 85?
Yeah. 84, 85.
So it took me like 6 years to kind of get there, and finally I came out, and then freestyle was already on its way out. Nobody wanted to play freestyle.
Shit, we did.
So, yeah, but radio didn't back then. So
yeah, radio was shifting, yeah.
So when it came out, you know, that's why I wanted, you know, I definitely have to tell my story, because people kind of, they tend to forget, you know, that it was on its way out, and now it's just on fire again.
Yeah.
And sometimes you got to give credit where credit is due. So I think when I came out, the record came out and started it all up again. So thank you to Carlos, because, you know, he never gave up.
Yeah.
And he never told me. So he kept me under wraps not to hurt my feelings, because if I would have known that for 2 years, he's shopping a deal and nobody's liking it and saying all these negative things about, you know, how it sounds and all that. So
did Carlos call you up?
He shielded me from.
Did he call you and say, "Hey, they're picking it up. They're playing here," or did you all of a sudden walking down the street and you heard it on the radio?
We were already like knee deep into, like, you know, just working and preparing ourselves for what's about to come, you know, and which we didn't know what was about to come. Whether it was I was going to get another regular job and he was just going to do whatever he did, and it was just he was just that type of man that when he believes in something, he goes for it. So.
Cool. Did you have a real job before all this, or did you?
I had many jobs. My first job was at David's Cookies. I was only like 16.
David's Cookies. Wow.
I went in. They had me mold the dough and all that stuff. I went out to lunch and I never came back.
There you go.
This is not for me. I was like, my hands are cold.
I got to go.
This is my job. My hands are cold. I was like, this is not working out. Then I got a job in a place called Wings on 86th Street where I lived. I worked there, went to lunch, never came back. I was like, they're having me folding too many clothes. Then I ended up getting a job as a dental assistant, but a receptionist in a dental office. Then from there, I worked for kind of a long time. I learned all the dental terminologies. So, you know, I had my jobs. I was never lazy. A story I never tell. I worked at Next Plateau.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
No kidding.
I worked there for like 2 weeks, and then I was like, this is not for me.
Not for me.
This is not happening. But you know what happened? They had a Rolodex.
Oh.
And I looked through all the contacts. I saw Mickey Garcia. I saw a whole bunch of producers.
Right.
And I called Mickey. And I went to see Mickey. He lived in, what's the name of that? Roosevelt Island. Mm-hmm. And I auditioned Come Into My Arms.
No kidding. Wow.
And, you know, he really was interested, and I got nervous about the deal, and I walked away.
Mickey Garcia is the guy who produced all the Seabake records, Mickey from Micmac Records, so Cynthia.
Johnny O,
et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Yeah. He's got a
So yeah, he, I auditioned for him, yeah.
No kidding. Come Into My Arms, too.
Come Into My Arms. So that's why I say, you know, there was a lot of inspiration. I used to go to clubs, and I used to watch everybody and be like, I want to do that. But I didn't know anyone. And I finally, you know, ended up meeting Tomac. So we created the boy-girl group. He knew Carlos. That was a DJ at Le Maurice. Mm-hmm. And in Queens. And I keep thinking I'm in New York, but in Queens, yeah. New York. And from there, you know, one thing led to the other.
That's awesome. Yeah. She's from New York.
I'm from New York.
Spanish Harlem, New York. Spanish Harlem, New York, yeah. Yeah. So I'm going to play Lydia Lee.
That's a song that I don't know. Is she performing still? What's
I don't know. I've never seen her here. This wasn't really a big record in Chicago, I don't think.
No.
I might be wrong, but
I don't think so either. Like
I moved here I moved to Chicago myself. I'm from Wisconsin. I moved here in 83.
Okay.
So I don't think.
And what was Because of You, the CoverGirls was pretty good.
Oh yeah, giant record, yeah.
What about Chrissy Ais?
Oh yeah, love it. I don't know, was it a radio record? Chrissy Ais, You Should Know By Now? Yeah, Chrissy? I know it was a big mix record. You know, that song was in the mixes a lot, along with, you know, Love Desire, which
right.
is my favorite, yeah.
See, I'm not sure that got a lot of airplay, right? It was more like
a DJ record.
Yeah,
more of a mix, underground DJ record, yeah.
That's what it was with Make Noise, too. Make Noise was more of a DJ record.
Yeah. Which is kind of cool. I mean, I know we're kind of getting off the beaten path here, but it's kind of cool for those underground records who don't have real lives, because they don't have a beginning or end. They just kind of float around. And, you know, they like to say, slow and steady wins the race. You know, take, for example, Dime a Girl. It wasn't really a radio record for a long, 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 long time. And it's still a staple. I mean, you can still, you know.
Yeah, right.
Sometimes you might. They might throw stuff at you when you're playing it. But, you know, no, it's still like, I always think that's a great example, because it's a record that really never had a beginning and an end. It just kind of surfaced, it kind of floated around,
that's
and
true.
They picked it up a little bit, and then it kind of went back underground again. So, you know, that's what I think of those records
and
are.
And the funny part about it, I don't know if you heard of a record called Tearshed?
Tearshed, yeah.
That's another record MPG. That never got airplay.
Yeah.
And it's a record that's underground. Right. People are still curious to know, like, where is this girl? Like, you know.
Yeah.
It's one of those cute little records. I wanted to know who the girl was. Like,
yeah.
I didn't have a deal. I didn't have anything. And I used to go around singing the record, too. I'm like, this is a cute record. But I don't know what ever happened. I'm so curious.
I'm going to play this one first, and I'll play Tearshed next. And then we can.
Tearshed.
You can listen to it. All right. Cool. This is Lydia Lee. I'll let you get a drink and do whatever you want. I'll just sit here and look good. This is Lydia Lee. It's called Don't Take Your Love Away. No battery. All right. We'll just cut it short. We'll just cut it short after.
Go.
There's Chelsea Baby. Classic from MKG, Tearshed, one of your favorites.
It's funny, yeah. I mean, I don't mean to say it's funny, but it's just one of the first songs that I heard. I'm like, who is and what's going on with this kind of music? So
yeah, Nelson Cruz swears that that's the first freestyle record.
What year did it come out? I don't know.
I'll check it out on Discogs. I don't know if that's it or not. We'll find that out.
We'll find that out in a minute. But let me ask you one question before we leave, because I know you want to do one. Why do you do what you do and do it so well?
Gosh, thank you. Thank you. What do you say about that? Well, you know, it's my passion, you know. Yeah. I love editing records. I like, you know, when I got on the radio with...
Can you repeat the question just in case you didn't hear it?
Yeah, just in case you didn't hear it, she asked me, why do I do what I do?
And why do you do it so well?
And why do I do it so well?
Oh, well. We got to add that in there.
Oh, shucks. Well, I'll tell you, you know, like I was talking about before, you know, I moved to Wisconsin from Wisconsin here in 83, and I wanted to be a DJ. I worked at a chain of nightclubs. And, you know, the cool thing is about when you move to someplace, you don't have any distractions. You don't know anybody. So I became very militant about what I was doing. And I didn't leave, you know, I didn't leave my room. Or I would go to the store on Tuesday. We would go to record, you know, the record pool, then go record shopping. And just, you know, I got club. I was in a club six nights a week. And that's all I did. That's all I wanted to do. You know, I wanted mix. That's all. And I don't have any other marketable skills besides this. So, well, that and bingo caller, but you can't really call that a profession, can you?
But did you gravitate automatically to just music overall?
Yeah, you know, I'm a you know, full-rounded DJ, a club, house music and club music. I always love, you know, I'm a house DJ, club music, get people dancing. But, you know, I was kind of gravitated towards, like, Exposé records that came out and everything. But what happened was I got on the radio with Bad Boy Bill and Julian Jumpin' Perez with B96. This is April of 89, and I knew I wasn't going to out-house Bad Boy Bill or Julian. I'm like, I got to find a little, I like this Exposé record, I like this George Lamont record,
right.
And I started playing Nelina that way, and I kind of, you know, made this my own genre, and and that's kind of my story. But I've always, you know, I've always had a passion for it, and, you know, and I don't, you know, I love good music. Love good records. Love my freestyle.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does. And he's the reason why I'm here, because I normally don't go out of my way to get anywhere a day before.
I'm so thankful, really. Liz, everybody, thank you. And you know what? Like I said,
thank you guys. And I'm not doing it to get extra kudos. I'm just saying, like, this is not what I do.
Yeah,
you know,
thank
so, you.
You
know,
thank
it's very
you.
Important.
That's love, right, Angie? Yeah. Yeah, yeah, that's love. Thank you. Thank you so much.
And you've been very receptive to anything. And obviously, you're breaking out all my records. And even the one that they screwed up my... I got to show this again.
Yeah, show it again. That's awesome.
This is hurtful. When this record came out, after years of trying to get a deal, I finally got a decent photo session because... Russell Simmons was also involved in this project, so he had all top of the line photographers and all. Yeah. So when I took the photo, my hair, if you look at the back, my hair is all down. I had this Puerto Rican Jerry curl looking thing. So I guess when they saw the front, they were like, I got to chop this off, you know, and I don't want to tell her. So they airbrushed all my hair.
Oh my God, that's hilarious.
Yeah. No, I mean.
Oh, you got your hair up in a bun.
Oh,
that's
kind of
cool.
Oh, you went there. No. They made me look a lot older than what I was because that's not the way I would wear, you know. So, you know, they were like, you look beautiful, and I like the face, but I literally cried. I was like, my record is out, but it was a bittersweet, you know, so I just had to share that.
It took a little longer for people to recognize you too then, right?
They didn't know what to make of me because I looked like that. Then I came out with a baseball cap and Doc Martens on. And then the next week I had high heels and a tight dress. I had no image. I didn't know where to go, you know. So finally I got it together and I knew who I was. And I started wearing the Doc Martens a little bit more with the hats and all that stuff. So trying to find yourself also having your own voice and your own style. And when you mentioned that you found your niche when you started playing those records, you found who you were and what you wanted to do. So that's important. You know, you have to know who you are.
You know. Perfect. Yeah, there you go. Thank you. So I think we did your whole repertoire.
You did. And I'm afraid I got to leave because I don't know what else you're going to pull out of there.
I don't know what it could be. How about He's My Baby? I'll tell you a little bit. He's My Baby now.
Okay.
Yeah, we had Brenda sing it. Her version, the Joy May version.
Right, Brenda has a version as well.
Yeah. Brenda, if you're still watching, we love you. She left her sweater.
She left her sweater?
I've been wearing it, hope you don't mind. Keep it under my pillow. I'm gonna send it back with Rex and Lizette. All right, Brenda.
You said everything to try to make me leave my baby. Don't try to break my heart by saying you'll never love me. He holds me, then he looks into my eyes and says, talking about the pain he left when he was yours. Stop trying to make me change my mind. Stop trying, just stop trying. Because you're part of what he's left behind. Just remember he's mine. He's my baby now. Whenever he wants me.
Everybody for Lissette Melendez! Wow, that was great. Thank you so much.